The Whiskey Brothers podcast is intended for an adult listening audience.
If you find yourself easily offended, I guarantee this will do it.
They don't want no problem. Nah.
From Houston, Texas.
The Whiskey Brothers podcast starts now.
We should do a show.
The pod calling coronavirus.
Welcome everybody to the Whiskey Brothers podcast. You don't get. No, one, it doesn't even make sense. Two.
Nah, it kind of does. Niggas is leading right now. It's sad. This shit has helped racism be alive again.
Okay.
Like, well, can I get in this store? We can't. Statistically, we can't let you in this store. Y'all are leading.
That may be the earliest episode title ever then. welcome to episode 800 and hang on. 456. Is this 7 and 8?
Shit,
this is 807. That's
there
where
you
we
go.
Are. I got it figured out. 807, Slateham, Trey Tutson, Rob Mungle.
Hey.
And we are joined by Zayed Devji, who has snuck into the studio through the dog door. what's up, buddy?
What's up?
Nothing. I'm happy to actually get out of the house. Actually, I'm in my house. I rebuilt the whole studio in my house.
So look, man, the technology is just amazing how you can almost green screen any background into Zoom. We welcome you guys watching us via the internet. We are live on our Facebook page.
Yeah.
We'll get over there and try and field some of your comments in the middle. In the meantime, we raise a glass. We are drinking from a bottle from the stash of our good friends over at the Old Humble Distilling Company.
Old Humble.
Always fans, always supporters of each other, I suppose. So, sláinte, gentlemen, and to killing germs on your lips.
Sláinte. Yeah.
See you over
That's
there.
That's Irish.
Sriracha.
Irish. It's an Irish toast.
Oh, God. What's that? Where's that from?
That's good.
From Ireland.
What happened? No, I'm saying, what did they do? What happened?
They got
did
a
they
word.
They had to pick some potatoes, and they was, like, grieving over it.
What?
Like, how did this word come about?
I was cilantro. I wasn't a cilantro.
You never heard that? He says that every fucking
cilantro.
Week.
Yeah.
No, he don't.
Brother, yeah.
He say cheers.
You know how I know you don't know? Your voice is getting high. And that's my...
cilantro? I ain't never heard you say some shit.
S-L-A-I-N-T.
That sound like spoiled meat. What's cilantro?
That sounds like Jay-Z getting mad.
Hang on, which microphone are you on?
Well, he's not talking into it.
There you go. Sorry. Yeah. That wasn't funny what I said. I feel bad. Start the episode now.
No. But then Rob wouldn't get his episode title. What?
Oh, yeah, I would.
Welcome, pot called Corona.
Yeah, that's pot calling Corona.
Yeah, so whatever. Say what you were going to say so I can do my shot.
Oh, it sounds like Solange.
Oh, it was
sounds
a.
Like Solange,
oh,
yeah.
God, that really wasn't worth it.
It wasn't worth it at all.
Okay,
this is what
happens
when
I go ahead and start the show over.
Off. 3 weeks off. And
yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're going to blame it on the off time, huh?
Yeah.
Not just what's within you.
No. Yeah. What? You know,
are we just going to sit here and not notice that Trey's sitting here with sunglasses on? Is that we got in the dark?
Here we go.
You know.
You know these are the glasses I'm supposed to be wearing, Rob.
Y'all
met me like this.
And yes, Rob. And I'll be honest with you. I don't question a black man's eyewear. Yeah. Ever.
Ever.
Ever. Inside, okay. Nighttime.
Well, then sláinte, if you've been wearing them all this time.
Oh, fuck. That means.
You look like you got those from the DL Ugly collection.
Ooh. You said that several times.
I have. I'm a stock comedian, but they're all my jokes.
Yeah, you are. Yeah. I got another one that's for me.
He plays the comedy club. I guess I had to be there.
This guy knows what he's talking about.
Yeah.
It's just fucking dude here.
God, I killed me.
Man. Can I tell everybody thank you? Tell me happy birthday, man. I really appreciate that. It was very hard.
Young Trey, it was your birthday yesterday.
Yeah.
And you had a good one, I assume?
Did you go to Chuck E. Cheese?
I had a... Oh, fuck you, Rob. I was there to rub some children. They weren't very interested.
What?
Did you go to Chuck D. Cheese?
No. Hey, Rob.
That's in the hood.
I like it.
Right,
Chuck
you play crack-a-mole.
That's two. That's two. Write it down, Slade.
I'm on it. Chuck, I'm on it.
Pizza was a hero to most.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
It takes a pizza of ingredients of a million to hold us back.
It's the only hip hop he knows.
Yeah. Is pepperoni replaced public or enemy?
Yeah.
It was
Chuck D. Cheese.
Chuck D. Cheese. That's really good. That's really good.
Yo, happy birthday, motherfucker.
Oh my God.
You played G-ball?
Yeah, boy.
That should be the podcast episode title.
Yeah, boy. Yeah.
It's your birthday, boy.
How many E's?
It's birthday. It's
birthday.
There's an F in
First
there.
First of all, yeah, it's birthday, by the way.
It's the only thing black people and English people have in common. The TH to F conversion.
Oh, yeah, and the slavery.
Yeah.
But, but anyway, yeah. I don't know how to skip that part. This motherfucker. Just breeze over that and go straight to a pronunciation.
No, it's your birthday.
Everybody thinks you're high, Trey. They all know why. Why is Trey wearing sunglasses? Trey, high as a bitch back there.
My eyes are crooked, man.
That's why you're wearing them?
Well, you know, I'm supposed to wear these, man.
Hey, I don't know how to pronounce this. Yote says Trey didn't even take a shot.
Yes, the fuck I did. It's gone, nigga. Where you at? Okay. All right, anyway. I had a swell birthday, man.
That's the special at Chuck D. Cheese. Hip-hop and you don't stop the buffet!
He's so irritated, it's hilarious.
The fuck was that?
He's looking at Trey's face. He's like, goddamn.
Oh, I wish I could see his eyes. Oh,
he's looking at me right now.
You can, man. They're outside the glasses. Like, they're peeking outside of them.
Your eyes are like Boo Radley.
Fucking sucks, man.
You used to wear that on stage for a while until I started telling you what the fuck.
No, I actually got better glasses.
Yeah.
It was no influence of anybody.
None?
No, I'm supposed to wear these.
I know. I don't. Sometimes I like it, but then when it's all the time, I'm like, ugh.
Yeah, you're like, he comes. Looking better than me, or whatever the fuck.
You have good style. I've said this before.
Yeah, I make you insecure about it. We've talked about
this. No, you don't make me insecure about style. I wore my Coogee sweater the other day.
But otherwise, it's mainly all denim.
You
have a lot of denim. Just how you got denim shirts.
I love them.
But
love
you also
them.
Mix everything together.
Yeah, that's
like,
true.
You don't give a fuck. Your shit will just look like a four-year-old's fucking paint.
I do like a good power clash.
Give me all the patterns, motherfucker. I don't give a shit.
You got mad at me for wearing a cardigan underneath a denim jacket.
Piss me off.
He's not wrong.
He looked terrible.
He's not wrong.
I don't even know how to wear a cardigan. But like, if I were to wear one
incorrectly, that's how you always
you
wear
look
them.
Terrible. You look like you wash Russian planes, nigga. Like, it was the worst. I was
wash
like,
Russian planes.
What are you doing right
Hope,
now?
Please. Tell me you don't know exactly what that person looks like right now. Rob, if blindly I said, hey, let's both draw a motherfucker who washes Russian planes.
Looks like looks like Nico off GTA 4, motherfucker. That's what you look like. Hold buddy, friend, what's going on? You come to America, you drive cab? Fathers didn't sacrifice for that. They would always say some deep shit.
That reminds me, I have to text my dad.
Oh, God.
What is problem? Yeah. Your carpet dash is not going to vacuum itself.
You got decent style, man.
Come
you
on. Just, I clean tassels. I clean everything.
What do you want? Yeah, birthday was
two jobs,
good,
washing
man.
Planes or gun runner. That's the only
gun
two.
Runner?
That's it. Only two jobs.
Come on. Get in the plane. I have already vacuumed carpet.
Yeah. We go through Triangle of Death. It's fine.
Giving Bert Kreischer a nickname. That's about it.
Oh, my God.
I had a
go ahead.
I had a cool birthday, despite.
What'd you do? Your girlfriend, your wife, your
no,
whichever
we had
one.
A threesome end in what? A hate crime.
What? Wait,
that's a big sentence.
Wait, we went through all that Chuck D. Cheese shit. And you buried the lead.
Did I text you?
No.
I didn't text you, about this.
You texted me, hey man, appreciate you. That was the last text
fuck.
I got from you.
Okay, you didn't black that up
a
enough.
A threesome
but
that ended in a
yeah. Okay, move that apostrophe three spaces. Appreciate right. You.
What you guys want? Crime? You guys want a story or y'all want to know what's up?
Let's do this in bullet points.
I'll try to do it.
What kind of choices do we have? A story or what's up?
Like, do you want to know? You want the shit to end to the segment or what? What's up? Fuck it, here goes, Rob. So right.
Do you want the truth or you want him to make this good?
Exactly. No, no, literally. Ouch. Ouch. Do you want it to be good?
Lie,
I don't know your story says the threesome ended in a hate crime.
I just want to know what the hate crime was.
All right, man, this is like a lot. But basically, you know, weekend, I go to my sister's house, my grandmother's birthday the day before.
Where all threesomes start.
Yeah, no, but... Well, I got to tell you. So we're there. Everybody's.
I don't like where this is going.
Crawl in the bed, wait for your parents.
Well, everybody, I'm kind of sad because my a little bit. My day gets overshadowed by my grandmother's all the time. Oh, so wow. Shay's like, how can we make your day
but
specifically
not for
special?
Forever.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. She was like, how can we make it special? Like,
eventually,
we got to kill grandma.
Win that one. Yeah.
We just got to kill grandma. What do you want to do? Hide the blood pressure medicine?
Chicken bone.
Let her stroke out in church? That'd be great. She already be where she's going to have the funeral at. So
just replace Shay with a white woman.
That would kill my grandma. No, but so I'm there. Everybody hates my hair. I'm getting called faggot more than ever in my life.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. So
big church word.
Yeah. So that's happened. So Shay was like, look, you know, the circle ended. She was like, do you miss the threesomes? And I was like, of course I do. Like, who the fuck would miss that every night?
She put an S on it, not do you miss threesomes with her. Like, do you miss threesomes?
Miss yeah.
Not that threesome.
Exactly. Kay. Do you miss them? And I was like,
do you miss pizza too? And, I don't know, water?
You know, Rob, I think about it all the time.
Yeah.
So she was like, yeah, do you miss it? I'm like, yeah, I miss it. I was like, all right. So she was like, well, look, of course we can't do that, but it's your birthday. Every year the last 3 years, we've done this. So... you down? I was like, yeah, all right, for sure. Whatever. She said
every year the last 3 years he's gotten a threesome for his birthday.
You don't want to stomp on tradition.
That's
so she's like,
we celebrate your wife, Trey. Yeah.
She's like,
as Robin said, we celebrate everything about her.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
In word and in song.
Okay. y'all lost me on that. That was one of them.
She has words and songs.
Steal the land riddles. That's fine.
So just hold this blanket and tell this story.
Yeah. I'm sorry. So she's like, hold this blanket. Yeah. So she's like, do you still want to have sex with a white chick?
Uh-oh.
I'm like, it's whatever. It's kind of like.
Man, that's a minefield, dude.
Yeah. So I'm like, I'm like, it's like whatever to me. It's kind of like when Houston got in and out. Like, I don't really care to eat it when we go to Austin now.
Right.
Because, like, when I get it, I get it. It's whatever. So she's like, all right, well, if I can make it happen. I was like, all right, you can make it happen. Cool. So she has this group that she got in where she would threaten D with. It's this group of like what they have, unicorn searchers. There's married couples on there. There's people that swing and all kind of shit. But if you're looking for a girlfriend, you could just say, hey, we're looking for a girlfriend.
Oh, it's where designated hitters hang out.
Shit like that. Yeah. So I was like, so she would threaten D with this shit all the time and be like, you know, she would threaten D. Like, we'll get another girlfriend. No, you're not. She would make the post. People would inbox her. Fuck with her, right? So she hit somebody up from there. He was like, hey, I got a white girl. Is this what you want to do? I was like, all right, cool.
How'd you get her?
Do the thing. Do the shit. Okay. Shay, she's interested in Shay.
Full
she's
of
never
unrolled
seen me.
Nickels.
Yeah. No. Yeah. Fucking what was that? A dart with a potato in it.
Just Shay holding a bottle of ranch dressing.
Yeah. Like, come on.
Ooh, so.
I know you guys like them.
Keep going.
What's the size range for a black couple looking for a white girl?
Oh, man.
Small, medium, large, extra large?
No, none of the large shit. We like I said, we don't need stacked mayonnaise. You know what I mean? We don't. I don't fucking need that in my life. I don't need that shit. It's just too sad. I don't need you looking like you need a scooter, you know, or fuck that. Like, let my dad be like, you got one, didn't you?
Right,
like,
yeah.
I want him to be proud and not like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, sure. You need to stick with these sisters or whatever. but anyway, she finds a chick or whatever. She's like, what's the rules? So the girl's excited and whatever. And I was like, look, first off, she's got to take a shower as soon as she gets here.
Okay.
That's immediate. She got to take a shower. And
wow, you can wipe the white off of a person?
No, legend is that white pussy smells weird. And I was just like, that's the legend. I don't know how true it is. So I'm like, look, you going to wash all this white shit off.
All right, everybody at the table want to take a vote on the legend.
The legend
it
of
smells
white
weird.
Pussy.
Now, if y'all,
that sounds like a Harry Potter I would watch.
Yeah, yeah, right?
Harry Potter and the Legend of White Pussy.
Mr. Potter.
Please, not yeast infection. Please.
Did it turn out that white pussy was one of the horcruxes? Was that? What are the odds?
Oh, man.
Where's cheese when we need
call her a horcrux.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Horcrux.
But the horrid horcrux.
Fucking a black chick is defense against the dark arts.
Do me a favor. Put a pin in this story.
Okay.
For 2 seconds. We're going to take a break because I know there's a lot more to this. We got people watching from all over the place. What's up, Shannon?
Shannon.
Yeah. Who else is author? Man, that's a hell of author, Dave Feffel. That's a lot of stuff. Listen from the UK.
You
dude,
sure
where
I didn't
in the UK?
You about this?
No, you didn't. I would remember this. 323-510-SHOT, 323-510-7468. The phone number, if you want to give us a call, you can always find us online, podcast@praisewhiskey.com, or leave us comments right there, man. I think Trey or somebody's going to stick around. Rob's going to have a cigarette. We're going to come right back with the Whiskey Brothers podcast.
Question, comment, just need to vent? Email us at podcast@praisewhiskey.com.
Welcome back then. We are the Whiskey Brothers, Trey Slade, Rob. We're joined by Zaya Devji. We are podcasting. Trey, you're in the middle of a story. Oh, I said that like it was in pro. We are podcasting.
We are
807 episodes in. I'm still saying shit like that.
We're on the World Wide Web.
Wow. You guys on the internet.
I'm having sex with you right now.
Make it feel like the first time, every time.
That's right. Making those ear babies. Come on.
All right, you got to take those glasses off.
For what?
Make it.
Because that. Like cause first that time.
Because you're going to sound like Barry White. You like the little midget inside Barry White's head.
Yeah. That's
wow, that's hilarious. Yeah.
Like you driving him around like
Hell
Men in Black.
Yeah, I'm Barry Brain.
I wish you could cue like soft funk music.
Oh my God, I know. I wish I had some handy.
Make it the first time.
That's
every time.
It's very light.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, baby. Get on that bearskin rug.
Get it in.
Let me refresh that 40.
God, refresh the 40.
Get you a beer on ice.
Let's make that. Let's make that, baby.
Do you know one of my favorite jokes of all time was from Zach Dixon? Okay. It was an impression of Barry White on helium. And he'd go, and the impression was him going, "Boy, do I love helium." So funny.
Zach is funny.
Goddamn,
hilarious.
All right, so you got you a non-mayonnaise slabbed white woman.
So yeah, so
you got, like where's describe this white woman? Where are you?
I'll show you a picture off.
Okay, here. That's fair.
I'll show you a picture later. But yeah, she's all right. She's not. She ain't like, woo, like fucking awesome. She ain't shit to brag about, but she's something to score with. You know what I mean? Like,
you don't mind having the window down.
Yeah, it's like for my first time, this is a good trial run. She's the AOL disc of white women. Okay. So I'm like,
oh, you got a base model.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's just like
manual door locks, no cruise control.
Yeah,
but it gets you from point A to point B.
Right, and no
point B being coming.
Well, you know, for some. So I'm anti-coming. So like we're there.
Sure. Sure.
Y'all like coming?
You're like the bulimic fucking, of sex.
Fucking,
this guy's literally an edgelord.
Coming is overrated. Edgelord.
Wait, what?
Coming is mad overrated because it's number one, the relaxation afterwards. You're like, bitch, you have melatonin in your pussy. What is like? What happened?
Trey, this is that is exactly when everyone should vote. Right there in that moment you're describing. Is when we should make all of our vital decisions should be made in that period.
This fucking clarity shit is ridiculous. That's also overrated. So, it's nigga, that's resentment and clarity.
Yeah. Hey, why don't you go put clarity over there in the box with the sex? Yeah. Oh, no. So we're throwing that one out.
Like clarity?
Put the money in there too.
Clarity?
Nothing positive's come from clarity. When I was just looking for clarity. That means the relationship's over. Like nobody was like, I was looking for clarity and it got better.
That's so funny.
Native Americans was looking for clarity. Like, yeah, nigga, this ain't your country no more. You're like, I'm glad I got clarity. So I got a casino to run, that's what you're saying? And it's eight of us. Fuck clarity, nigga.
Oh my God.
Get the fuck out of here. Y'all thinking wrong. So
eight people running a casino? That's too many chiefs.
too many chiefs.
Not enough Indians.
How many Indians does it take to run a casino into the ground?
Oh God.
Just one chief.
But you could have taken the food and beverage job. You had to be out front.
My Native American name is actually Sitting Drunk.
Your brother bankruptcy. So,
do you guys still want me to valet park the cars?
Russians
back.
Russians back.
I was like, when did the Romanians start running the casino?
I can't do accents. Leave me alone.
No shit.
Slade, do Chinese.
Every day in my country.
Like, just every time.
Every time he does Russian.
Who ordered the number 64?
Okay.
All right. So. God,
that's funny.
All right. So I'm here with this snow roll.
And snow roll.
It's a nickname for chunky white women.
Yeah, no shit.
She's a snow roll.
Yeah. Not a little Debbie snack.
Yeah.
It just popped into my head. It's an April marshmallow man.
Who wanted some snow change? So I dude. So she's like, all right, I'm cool with that rule. I'll take a bath. You know, I'll be. I'll,
oh, I forgot that was the rule. I was like, where were we?
Yeah, she has to take a shower.
They found her on a Facebook group. They talked her into taking a shower.
Yeah.
Don't mess up the good part.
Yeah. So
if you find any clarity on your body in that shower. Wash it off.
So she just, did y'all go scoop her, or did y'all just text her an address? And
she Ubered.
Of course.
So she Ubered over. So
was there? Did she awkwardly knock on the door?
Hey,
I'm here to get fucked by two people.
Not, you know, our window's open. So we can kind of like, oh.
Clearly the window's open.
You were like, there's the white bitch. So we're like,
oh, you
got to
let the white pussy air out.
Exactly, because it smells weird. It smells weird. Also, my myth is ruined. White pussy does not come with a rape whistle. But anyway, so I thought they all did.
I think they should call them anti-rape whistles.
You know, you make such a good point.
Because it sounds like you're like, I'm doing it. You're calling.
Takes the shower and everything's about to get going. So it's kind of getting like heated and she's doing the.
I don't hear any scrubbing in there.
Yeah.
It sounds like water.
Man, she's going through your medicine cabinets.
Look at all kind of shit.
I'm going to check that loofah. I'm going to check that loofah.
Yeah.
That's,
oh, man.
By the way, that's an impression of the girl.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, man. Her hair was shedding. I ain't going to lie about that. That was a weird thing.
Right, so what happened to I Can't Believe but, It's Not Cocoa Butter?
Oh, that was next. So when she gets out of the shower, she dries off. And she was like, all right. Shay was like, nah, bitch, you're going to have to lotion. She was like, so it started out there. We lotioned her down, which felt new to her.
We lotioned her down.
It was like, cool. I was like, I've never seen pink nipples live.
Would have been less creepy if y'all put the lotion in the basket. That's a This is an odd night right now.
So we lotioned her down. We got her oiled up. It was getting soothing. So
y'all giving her too many chances to change her mind.
She's in it. So everything gets rolling. Everything starts.
The check cleared, man. She's there.
Yeah. So she's like, all right, can I have some fun? Can I have fun? And I was like, all right. She was like, remember I said the thing about the fun? I took the shower. Now it's my thing. She was like, all right, cool. So
did she clarify in her ad what fun was?
No. So she starts sucking.
You said it ended in a hate crime.
So she's sucking my dick. She's doing my deal. And I'm like, oh, this is pretty good. It's like white head. I never had that before. All right, this is like fantastic. The lips are small, but all right, it's cool. Y'all shit is thin. It's like getting your dick sucked by a wheat thin. Like, it's ridiculous. So she's... She's like sucking my dick or whatever, and it's fine. And then she like reaches in her bag and pulls out some coke and snorts the coke off my dick. I was like, oh, all right.
Oh,
like,
Rob woke back up.
I was like, whoa. Like, you know, so I'm like, all right, cool. This is the fun. So we're getting into it.
And she could definitely see the line.
Yeah. So she snorts the coke and
oh, God. It's like a diamond, but they put it out.
That took me a second, but I got it.
Isn't that my whole brand?
She almost said that. She was like, this is much better on black dick. Oh, my God. I didn't leave any leftover coke. Like, this is great. She snorts the coke, asks me for some. I'm like, I'll pass. I'm fine. So, good. She drinks a little bit. It's like, it's weird. It's like sexual, but like the fun is happening. She's like drinking. It's like real fun. It's getting hot and stuff. And then she starts jerking my dick. We already have some fun. Can we have fun? She's like saying all this weird, really like kind of porn type shit. This high-pitched white girl, sexy voice shit.
Right.
Yeah, you want to have some fun? You want some fun? So she starts sucking my dick. And she just like goes, yeah, yeah.
This would not be the part of the story where I start giggling.
She goes, yeah, yeah. Give me some of that nigger dick.
Oh.
So so then Shay goes.
I mean, you think it. Shay you don't say it.
So
inside voice.
Yeah. She goes, give me some of that.
Like,
wow. Give me some of that nigger dick.
Jesus Christ.
I go, pardon me. Because I didn't know.
Oh, that is when you code switch. For sure, you code switch right there.
I swear to God.
Pardon me?
Because it still is a white woman. You know what I mean? I can't help but code switch. I see blonde hair. I'm like, pardon me? And she's pardon like, me? You heard me. Give me that nigger dick. So Shay
like
was like
a oh,
she thought, it, yeah. she thought it was like a, I can't hear y'all. Like a,
yeah. She, which, who the I, fuck?
You're not running halftime for the Rockets.
And
I
who the,
can't hear you.
Who the fuck says pardon me in the middle of a cheer? Like, whose house? Pardon me? Our house. Like, who the fuck?
A Oh, you've never been to a football game in River Oaks. That's
I just picture a sea of white men with ascots.
Oh, yeah, that's some shit you do at a cricket match.
Yeah.
Whose house?
With a crystal glass of Cavassier or some shit. Pardon me.
So when the second time.
So she goes. Yeah.
Now, how'd Shay react the first time? I know you pardoned
me. She
meter.
Didn't like. She was. Shay stopped. Everything stopped. The pussy dried up immediately. That, like, she was
right.
Like, give me that nigger dick. No more pussy. It was like gone. Holy I was God. Like, ah, shit. But she was like quiet.
Wait a minute, Mr. Candy. We got to burn down the house. So she, that white woman bring that pussy in here. We got to burn down the house, Mr. Candy.
So she goes, you know, pardon me. So I say pardon me as Shay pussy dries up. It was like a, you know, it was like a unit, you know, act in unison.
Right.
And then, so
you were saying it to both of them.
So I say, pardon me. The white girl says, you give me that nigger dick.
She thought you literally meant like you couldn't hear her.
That's, yeah. That's or, you know, can you repeat that?
Yeah.
I think I'm going to fucking spell it bee. So,
could you use it in a sentence?
Can you repeat the word? Nigger dick. Can you use it in a sentence?
Yeah.
Give me that nigger dick. Yeah.
I don't know if you know, that was the winning word in the Crips spelling bee last year. That was the
what
Crips
is the origin? Spelling bee. Indonesia. I don't fucking know. Nigger
What's
dick.
The origin? 1800s America.
Yeah.
We know exactly.
Pretty sure.
What's the origin? Swing low, Mississippi. Cottonfield. That's the origin.
Oh, my God.
So, all right. So, she goes, so then she's like, so after she said, give me that nigger dick.
So, are we done?
Shay goes, uh-uh, bitch. That's what Shay's response. Uh-uh, bitch. Hold on. Nuh-uh. Right. No, right. We ain't doing that. She's like, no, y'all said I could have fun.
Oh, shit. So that's fun?
She goes, so give me this nigger dick. And she's jerking my dick. Like, give me this nigger. Give me my. So, Shay is offended. And tackles this bitch like proves somebody skipped out on her in the draft. You know what I mean? Like she should have been virtually called some shit. Oh with the 7th pick, the 49ers select.
Defensive end.
You can see right here the tape shows when a nigger dick is called, she turns into Bobby Boucher. So
yeah, we're just gonna say Omaha from here on out. That's
that's an accidental pun, Bobby Boucher. Oh. But anyway, I didn't mean that anyway.
Trey.
So she tackles her, and they're tussling, and I'm trying to get in between them.
And Trey's like, now finally, I get to have fun.
I get it as simultaneously as I'm trying to get in between them to break up the fight. As they're screaming, a cop comes in the house.
What?
Because this is later I found out. Somebody, when she's like screaming
must
all
have
this
followed
shit.
Her from the truck stop.
Yeah, and she's talking loud throughout the whole shit. So somebody called the disturbance thing. Oh. So the cop shows up. The window's open. So he looks in and just sees
a
us
white woman
tussling.
Being accosted.
Yes, us tussling.
And everyone's naked.
He charges in, shoves me to the ground.
What
handcuffs me, puts me in. I'm in the corner.
Naked?
Naked. Like, like some sort of fucking.
Dude, you never brought this up once. We hung out for hours yesterday.
No, you did not text
I thought
me.
I told y'all about this.
We hung out for
Bro,
hours yesterday.
I'm in the corner. You know, fucked up, like naked and shit, and like, you know, fucking threesome time out or some shit. And then the cop gets up, he separates him or whatever. So he's about, what's going on? What's happening? Everybody's naked and shit. What's going on? And the cop was about to arrest me. So Shay's like explaining to him, no, fuck that. You know, this is what happened. And Shay had all the text messages that's showing everything. She agreed to come over here, blah, 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 because the white girl started to cry wolf. Like, she started to be on some dumb shit. So she shows the cops the messages, blah, blah, blah. I'm fucking in handcuffs for a while. And Shay told him what she said.
Not
she
in the
said,
good way.
She said, nigger dick, blah, blah, blah. And I had, like, a couple slices on my dick. Shay was like, that is like she assaulted his penis because he stopped after a while. He didn't want anything anymore. And she did the thing.
Slices?
So the cop. Well, he stretches. Left me because he then takes the cuffs off of me, handcuffs her, and told her like,
"Wait,
no,
he never handcuffed her.
He never handcuffed her.
Not until the end.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Oh,
that's how it works.
God. But we all still naked. He takes the cuffs off me, puts the cuffs on her, and then he was like, he told her like the charge is probably going to be a hate crime.
Oh my God!
What?
Because she brutally assaulted my dick while saying nigger.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, that's like the greatest birthday ever.
Trey Tutson.
What a time to not do stand-up.
Why are you kidding me?
This is like,
I don't think he called nobody for this.
Before we get out of here, I don't think he even deserves this story, considering he thinks he told all of us already. Yeah. Like, how could you be that careless?
No, I thought I for sure told you yesterday. No, we talked about a lot of stuff.
We're easy to find. You guys, you've been leaving messages. We've been.
That's like one of the most insane stories.
Anyway, I'll show you the girl.
Yeah. I want to see.
there's a mugshot.
What if it's Tommy Lauren? We're like, well, you should have started with that. That makes sense.
But man,
Joe Breda, we are.
Oh, but by the way, still haven't fucked a white woman.
Joe, we are almost empty. In fact, we are empty.
It does seem like a white woman fucked you, though.
What's up, Scott Lane? Bunch of people hanging out.
I fucked over a white woman.
Find us on a future episode, man. We'll see you guys, Jesus, Trey, soon. Thanks for being here, Zion.
They don't want no problem. Nah.
Music provided by
Scarface.
Thank you for listening to yet another excellent episode of the Whiskey Brothers Podcast, the world's funniest podcast
ever.
The Whiskey Brothers Podcast was made in America by Americans, mostly in and around the Houston area.
All content copyright the Whiskey Brothers.
This concludes our broadcast day. Goodbye.